Lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer death in the U.S. and worldwide. Now, there are things you can do to reduce your chances of getting the disease. Dr. Richard Lee, a radiation oncologist with the Cancer Center of Hawaii, is here with more on that. Hello, doctor.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So, doctor, tell us about lung cancer.
As you mentioned, lung cancer is the most common and most common cancer, and it's the leading cause of death, cancer death, in the United States and worldwide. Around 160,000 people pass away from this disease. The reason why it's such a tough disease is because we catch them at a very late stage, and so it's really hard to manage.
Okay, and why do we catch it at such a late stage?
Because there are no screening programs for lung cancer. And the reason why, and the only way we can actually prevent lung cancer is by reducing high-risk behaviors. And these high-risk behaviors are smoking and exposures to secondhand smoke. So a common thing that I tell people from the outside that are public is that if you're smoking, you should stop smoking. If you're around people who are smoking, you should stay away from them and tell them to stop smoking. And if you want to know when to stop smoking, the time is now.
So this seems like a preventable cancer.
Yes. 90%, over 90% of all lung cancers are associated with smoking. They always have a history of smoking.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, let's talk about treatment. If someone has lung cancer, what can they do?
So the way I like to start out is, like, you know, in terms of screening, there is no screening programs, but people with high-risk behaviors, that's like their age and the number of years of pack years of smoking. The pack years of smoking is defined as the number of packs per day times the number of years. So in other words, if you have a 30 pack year history, that could be one pack per day for 30 years or two packs for 15 years. Mm. So if you have a basically 50 or over, a 30 pack year history, and you stop smoking within the last 15 years, you're eligible for what we call a CT screening program, low-dose CT screening program. And what they found was with people with these high-risk behaviors, they can reduce the risk of lung cancer death in this population.
Okay, can you tell me more about the screening? What happens during those screenings?
So when they do the CT-based screening, they do a CT scan for these population of patients, and then they'll find, like, some abnormal findings, like a little nodule in the lung cancer screening. And what they'll do is, well, let's screen again in 3 months to see if it grows in size. And if it grows in size, they might be eligible for what they call a biopsy to see exactly what that is. And if it's cancer, we can treat it at an early stage versus at an advanced stage where it's tough to treat.
Okay, so what are the treatment options available for someone who has lung cancer?
So if you catch it early, the first thing that you'll need to be evaluated is by a cardiothoracic surgeon, where they'll be determine whether they're a surgical candidate, where they can cut it out. And if they're not a surgical candidate, they could be eligible for radiation therapy alone. And we have techniques at our Cancer Center of Hawaii where we use SBRT, stereotactic mm-hmm. body radiation therapy, where we can do a high dose of radiation over 5 treatments or less.
Okay, we actually did a story on SBRT, so I know a little bit about it, but it is high dosage in a very focused area.
Right.
Okay.
And we basically create, like, these frame sets that immobilize the patient so we can give that at a very precise treatment area.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Anything else we should know about lung cancer?
The main thing is, if you're smoking, you should stop. And if you know people smoking, you tell them to stop, and the best time is now.
Mm-hmm. I do feel like there's been kind of a, I mean, you know, when my kids now see people smoking, there's been a lot of education in schools, you know, to catch it early, to explain to them how dangerous smoking is, how bad it is for your body. Mm-hmm. So it's nice that there's this real effort to teach kids the dangers of smoking.
And yes, I agree. And another thing is about the high-risk behaviors is talk to your primary care physician. Talk mm-hmm. to your, they'll know all the different risk factors, because mm-hmm. the ones I just named are just a couple, and there's several others that needs to be determined.
All right, Dr. Lee, thank you very much.
No, thank you.
Thank you.